not my, like, skull, but my, I'm bleeding and I have a little scar over here.
We barely stopped.
Yeah, we came back a few hours later. Yeah. But, yeah, no, and I thought actually that I had some problem because I couldn't hear everybody well, and I thought, oh my God, I've done it, I've got a concussion, and I had forgotten I had my ear plugged in. I was fine. Well, part of it is that I love doing action and I love doing dramatic films, but I've never really been able to combine them. And as for action, it's sometimes, you know, I've had so much fun doing certain films, but you can get away with so much when it's fantasy. You can bend a bullet, you can jump off something that doesn't really exist, or you can. And you can have fun and you can stretch your imagination, but for this one it was just such a nice challenge to say, we have to work so much harder to convince the audience that all these things are absolutely possible. And so my style got meaner and harder and darker. It wasn't as much fun and free, and that made it, I think, better. I think these stunts of this movie is a better action movie than the ones I've done. So yeah, that and the character. I think she's a fascinating character. You can never talk about her because it's all a secret, and you have to let the pieces unravel. But she's a really interesting, kind of damaged, unusual type of person. So I think people relate to her in a very human way and identify with her. There was a real duplicity to her personality, and there's a part of her that's not necessarily a good guy. And because of certain things that happened in her organization, she's a bit damaged. So she's not just heroic, and she's not even, and she's not just brave. There's something a little off about her. And maybe there's still something off about me. So it seemed like a good match.